Right now, I'm joined by John Bramnick. John is the Assembly Republican leader in the Republican in the state assembly, and he is leading the effort to change the majority in the assembly. The election's coming up on November 3rd. John, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Thanks, Bill. You know, you asked the question of what something has to be done. Well, clearly, when you had the Democrats in charge of the legislature for 14 years, they feel invincible. They don't really have to answer the questions you asked this morning. This bill, whether it's a good bill or a bad bill, it actually makes some sense, is not the main issue in Trenton. So my feeling is that the Democratic majority has to post some really significant bills to change the tax situation in the state. If they do that, then we can talk about some minor legislation. But here, minor legislation has taken over all the airwaves. Not one discussion other than yours, as to the fact they've been charged for 13 or 14 years and have only made this state more expensive.
Yeah. What do we need to do about it, John? Because I think I had this conversation earlier. We had some candidates call in and we've had the conversation. To me, there's some low-hanging fruit on things like the gas tax. Like you talk about minor legislation. So on one side, minor legislation like this ridiculous change in the law about mental health records being expunged, it's not going to solve anything because there wasn't a problem in the beginning that they were even addressing, other than perhaps something administrative or, you know, that the judges wanted because it makes their life easier. You know, the judges that supported this legislation, my guess is they just wanted less accountability for themselves.
No, look, this is not a bad idea. I mean, even the NRA supported this bill, but this is not. But that's not.
Doesn't address the problem.
It's a smokescreen.
Yeah.
Here we have billions of dollars of entitlements. We have a bipartisan committee that says how we save billions at the state level. And the Democratic leaders will not take up a bipartisan commission's report. They won't talk about it on the floor. Now, if you were able to do that, you could send more money to school systems, and that would reduce local property taxes. Not discussed. School formula. The school formula that says send $500 million to Jersey City, despite the success of Jersey City. Not discussed. What do they discuss? Let's override the governor. That was the discussion. And to me, that's disingenuous because it avoids the real important problems in the state.
Now, John, it has to go to the assembly. Is the assembly going to vote to override the veto?
I can't tell you. I'm having a discussion today, actually, at 2:30 with all my members. My position is this. You want to post some really important bills and change the direction of this state? I'll talk to you about a minor bill. But I'm not talking to you about a minor bill and making that the bill of the day or the bill of the year when you've made this state as expensive as it is. Let's get the real issues in front of the state legislature. And in my judgment, that's probably not going to happen until we change who runs the legislature.
So if you're going to score this, you think it's you give it 50-50 that the governor's veto is overridden in the assembly, or no? Is it more 80-20?
That's a tough one. I'm hoping that Tom Kane Jr.'s bill is the one that we discussed, but I can't speak for the other members until I speak to them, and I don't want to handicap stuff.
Fair enough.
I'm not good at the racetrack or Atlanta.
Fair enough, John. Stick to politics and, you know, and a little bit of law. All right,
thanks,
John Bramnick, I appreciate you joining me on New Jersey 101.5. We'll be talking soon.